I'm Eunice, a product manager with Teams Engineering, and I'm super excited to be here at Build in Seattle. With me, I have Jeremy Thake and Barnam Bora.
Hey, Eunice.
Hey, how's it going?
It's good.
So I have intercepted the two of you fresh out of your session on Copilot Extensibility, where you talked about, plugins, connectors, declarative copilots, and custom engine copilots. Quite a lot to take in. So for the people who are tuning in to watch this snippet, what are the two top things you want them to take away from your session? Jeremy?
Yeah, I think for me, the whole process of giving guidance, at Build last year, we announced message extension plugins and graph connectors, and it was new to us. It was new technology, right? We were showing how you could take existing platform technologies and bring them and use them in Copilot for Microsoft 365. And now, a year later, we've been working, and I know you have especially been working with a lot of partners building these things, and we got to showcase all that good work directly in the session, in the keynote with Jeff Tipa and Rajesh. And it was really exciting to not only demonstrate the art of the possible with real-world scenarios, but to give guidance from all the lessons we've had, from all the conversations we've been having with those partners and customers. And so the takeaway for me was we gave that developer guide, we gave that wayfinding of why should I use a plugin? Why should I use a graph connector? Why should I use a declarative copilot and a custom engine copilot? And we bridged that balance between kind of both sides of building on our AI platform, and then you covered building on your AI platform. And so for me, that was a big takeaway. And then I think the second one for me was, we've learned a lot in the last year around message extension plugins as a way to take your existing investments and bring them into Copilot. But with API plugins, which we've announced today, effectively, if you've got an API out there, wrap it in a manifest and deploy it as a plugin, and you're away to the races as a team app and pushing that and making that available in Copilot for Microsoft 365. And so for me, that's my second biggest takeaway, is anyone that has an API can very quickly get your data into Copilot Microsoft 365 to both summarize and act on top of our AI platform, which I think is a really cool thing of how we can give opportunity both to software companies and to customers.
It sounds like a real game changer. So where would you keep your eye on for new innovations in the plugin space?
Yeah, so I think from that perspective of how do you keep up, ako.ms/m365copilot dev is the best website to go to. That's where all our docs are with this guidance, along with all the getting started, the tutorials, the samples, and some great videos, including all the videos from Build this week. So that's definitely the best place to go.
How about you, Barnam? Do you agree with Jeremy? Are you most excited about plugins?
Jeremy's, in my opinion, a very biased guy. He loves his stuff. But I love my stuff too. So I'm a very tools guy. I love optionality. And frankly, we're in an era where we are creating new realities for people possible. Copilot's building the ability to go and do things which were never possible. And what I really like about how we are enabling extensibility on our platform is that we're not just saying just build with this particular engine that we have. We're saying you can build your own copilot on top of this. You can go build a declarative copilot using natural language instruction set, saying I want to use that plugin, I want to use that connector, I want you to focus on this particular piece of information and create generations on that. Or if in scenarios where you have custom logic, automation, your business depends on critical systems that you've already built, you want to build Copilot as a front end to that and bring that intelligence and to the fore into our hubs or your own custom UX, custom engine copilots are the way to go. And those are kind of that spectrum of options that we have is what we talked about in our session, and enabling our developers to choose which particular style of extensibility is the right for that particular scenario on that particular day for that particular business outcome. That's what I'm really excited about.
Wow, that's pretty amazing. So if someone wanted to build a declarative copilot or a custom copilot now, where would you send them to start?
Well, actually, we have multiple options. Where we have both low-code and pro-code options to build declarative and custom engine copilots. If you want to go and build one of these your own copilots today, I would actually point you to the pro-code pathway using Teams Toolkit and Visual Studio Code. Today, you want to start right now. We've got samples, we've got examples, we've got videos coming out. We showed a bunch in our own session as well. But very soon, you'll also have access to a low-code platform, which we also showed in a keynote as well, which is called Copilot Studio, which allows you to actually do a click through you know, low code environment to go build your own copilots and declaratives as well. And you know, the combination of the, again, the both of these ends of the spectrum, you can try wherever, but I would say today's call to action, I'd say go download Teams Toolkit, download AI Library, and go build your own copilots right now.
Okay, that's pretty amazing. Thank you so much for joining us today. Now, if you want to watch Barnam do this code live, be sure to check out their session, aka.ms/150. Also, if you happen to be here, don't forget to check out Growing Your Business with Copilot Extensions by our Vice President, Srini Raghavan. It's available at aka.ms/147 if you want to add it to your calendar, or it will be available online as well. Thanks, everyone. Have a great build.